Sir Patrick Spens. Introduction. It is a ballad by an unknown author. Ballads are poems written to be sung. Ballads often tell tragic stories, and it may or may not have connection with history. Sir Patrick Spens deals with the theme of mortality and role of faith in the life of people. According to Francis James Child's English and Scottish Popular Ballads, the present ballad have connection with historical incidents in which Patrick Spens, the sailor guide in a shipwreck, poem. The king sits in Dumfarling town, drinking the blue dreed wine. Oh, how will I get good sailor to sail this ship of mine? Up and spake an elder nicht, five, sat at the king's ricked knee. Sir Patrick Spens is the best sailor that sails upon the sea. The king has written a braid letter and signed it with his hand, 10, and sent it to Sir Patrick Spens. Was walking on the sand. The first line that Sir Patrick read, aloud louch louched he. The next line that Sir Patrick read, 15, the tear blinded his ee. Oh, where is this has done this dead? This ill dared done to me, to send me out this time o' the year, to sail upon the sea? 20. Make haste, my merry men all. Our good ship sails the morn. O't say nassy, my master dear, for I fear a deadly storm. Late, late yestreen I saw the new moon 25, with the old moon in her arm. And I fear, my dear master, that we will come to harm. Oh, us Scots nobles were ricked loth to weet their cork-hiled schoon, 30. But lang o'er ere the play were played, their hats they swam aboon. Oh, lang, lang may the ladies stand with their fans into their hand, or ere they see Sir Patrick Spens, 35, come sailing to the land. Oh, lang, lang may the ladies stand with their gold kerns in their hair, waiting for their ain dear lords, for they'll see them now mire. 40. Have o'er to Aberdare. It's 50 fadum deep, and tear lies good Sir Patrick Spens, with the Scots lords at his feet. Analysis of the poem. The King of Scotland is introduced in the beginning. Sits refers to the idea that he is seated firm in his power and makes others move. The ease with which he controls other people's lives is suggested by the blood-red wine in the first line. The king selects Sir Patrick Spens as his sailor. Though it is an honor, it is a difficult task for anyone. The elder knight praises Sir Patrick Spens, saying that he is the world's best sailor. Patrick receives a letter from the king appointing him as his sailor. He reads the letter and laughs, thinking that it is a joke. Realizing that the king is serious, he became aware that the mission will be a dangerous one and his death is certain. He suspects the elder knight to be behind this evil action. The sailors under him also aware of the dangers involved in this, but follow his order just as he did. They are welcomed by a bad omen. The new moon is in the old moon's arm in the ship. The nobles are curious about setting even their shoes, but it is true that they are going to be drowned. The journey can be seen as a play. The women wait for their noble lords to return. But it is true that the man belongs to death rather than to them. The ship is wrecked in the storm. The ship and the men lie 50 fathoms deep in the sea. Themes. 1. Power. The ballad centers on the theme of power. The king is the center of authority and power. He decides the fate of the people. Patrick had no other way but to obey the orders. The elderly knight who informs the king about Patrick is another power center. Sir Patrick, in a way, also exercises power over the sailor's death. In this poem, death is personified in the figure of the king. The red wine that he drinks is a suggestion of blood. Even though the sailors are aware of the danger, they accept it without protest because they knew that they are destined to die.